Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to episode 17 of Funs with Huns. I have to warn you right at the beginning, this episode is going to be different from the rest of the episode that you watched, for multiple reasons. I got stories to tell you, I got pictures to show you, I got mobile phone videos to show you. So I'm warning you immediately that the quality is going to be kind of iffy. And I got kind of a sneak previews, although it's been published already, but I'm guessing there's a lot of you who still don't know about it. Super test changes, replay. It's just, I don't know how long this episode is going to last. I'm going to try to not make it too long. I'm actually contemplating at this point to make it into two episodes. One is going to be just the regular Funs with Huns, where I have open hands to do pretty much anything. And one is going to be probably completely unrelated to Funs with Huns, where I just do the technicalities of what I want to talk about, which is directly related to World of Warships. First of all, I want to kind of start showing you the pictures and the videos immediately, but I will leave this intro Funs with Huns picture before I get you into everything. Like I said, I don't know if there's going to be an actual battle replay in this match. I do have one ready, but I don't know how much time is it going to take me for me to show you everything else. And what I'm talking about is, without any further ado, let's jump right into the story. Okay, so last Thursday or Friday, me and Mrs. Citadel decided that we're going to go watch John Wick 3. Now, we have both seen John Wick 1, but this was a long time ago. I've seen John Wick 2, she hasn't. So we decided before the movies, a night before, we're going to watch John Wick 2 together. So we did. And I'm not going to spoil you anything about John Wick 3. Don't worry. I'm just going to say it was a fantastic movie. Definitely worth watching. And the only thing I want to mention is we watched John Wick 2. And you know, it's kind of a shooter, action, killer thingy. Something like James Bond and Jackie Chan combined on steroids. I don't know. And you would think that after watching John Wick 2, you wouldn't be really very enthusiastic to go and see John Wick 3, right? It's a similar thing. Wow, John Wick 3 was actually pretty amazing. Especially after watching John Wick 2, you expect to not get surprised. It was a surprise. It's got a couple of scenes which I would rather if they didn't show me, because it's gore. Whoever watched the movie will know exactly the two scenes that I'm talking about. They're very short, but they're very gruesome. But the rest is pretty awesome. Anyway, I don't want to keep you on this forever. So, we decided we're going to go watch John Wick 3. Now, at the moment of time, we had to go through car registration and technical and all that stuff. So, we decided, okay, we're going to go for a walk. It's about 15-20 minute walk. Right about few minutes before we arrive at our destination on one of the biggest roads, of course, we're walking on a sidewalk and then there's grass and stuff on both sides. We heard some weird noises. Now, Mrs. Citadel immediately jumped to conclusions and said, cats, 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 this got to be a cat. And I'm thinking, this doesn't really sound like a cat. It sounds more like a duck or seagull or something combined. I don't know. We just continued walking. We went to the movie. It was, I think, a bit above 2 hour movie. We watched through it all. Of course, you have to arrive a bit earlier. And then went to the bathroom afterwards. And we went back home, which is from the time we heard those noises almost 3 hours later. We're walking the same passage and we still hear on exactly the same place. We are still hearing these weird sounds, these weird noises. And Mrs. Citadel is, I'm telling you, this is cat. And I'm thinking to myself as a kid, which was super long time ago, but I really had a lot of cats. I've never heard a cat being like this. Okay, okay, woman, fine. I went into the grass and that's when I found this little thing. It is the cutest thing in the world. She was standing there. It's a she, by the way. She was standing in the in these high grass that you can see behind. This is Mrs. Citadel holding her in her leather jacket. We had no idea if she had anything. We didn't really want to do too much cuddling or touching. But she was making the weirdest and cutest sounds in the world. And it was like, wow, we can't leave her here. And she definitely didn't look like she had someone taking care of her. We took her, and then we decided you can't actually see it here because her head was relatively clean. But from back here, her whole body was filled with these things that are basically in the grass. If you're walking and then they get kind of stuck on your clothes, they're not living things. They're just little, I think they're called picks, somebody told me. I'm not sure. You'll know what I mean. Anyone who ever walked through grass probably collected a couple of these things. She was absolutely crawling with them. I think she had between a 50 and 100. And she looked really skinny, really frightened. She wasn't even trying to escape or anything. So Mrs. Citadel just took her, put her in the jacket. And we decided, screw it. We're going to take her home. We're going to, you know, try to take her over the night and then take her to the vet in the day after. This was already like 11:30, 12 p.m., basically midnight. So, okay. I was resisting forever to get a cat because as much as I love animals, cats and dogs both, and I had them in the past, I'm not a huge fan of keeping an animal in the apartment, especially the apartment that we have. It's a lot better than where we were, but it could be better. But of course, Mrs. Citadel was, we gotta take care of her. And I'm like, yeah, of course, we can't leave her here. So we decided to take her. She was pretty calm right about, I don't know, a few minutes before we arrived. And then she started wanting to leave. My guess is she was really hot underneath this leather jacket because we wrapped her up good so she can't escape. This is a huge main road right next to the sidewalk. And it was pretty hot. As you can see, we're in short sleeves. So maybe that was the reason, I don't know. So we took her to the apartment. I sit next to the, well, it's not a bathtub, it's a shower cabin. And I started picking her clean, picking all of those things out of her. It took me like an half an hour to take it all out. She was extremely calm and gentle and she wasn't complaining or trying to escape or anything like that. She was the most calm cat I've ever seen. And after that, I gave her a shower, which was a shocking experience for me because I know cats don't like water very much. Some of them are weird, but most of the cats, like 99%, are freaking frightened of the water and they want to escape. I took a little pot, filled it with warm water, put a little baby shampoo that we had, stirred it up a bit, and put the cat inside, and she didn't say a word. She didn't move. She didn't flicker, twitch, anything. She was just standing there, and I'm thinking, wow, I was already prepared to have a battle here to wash you. And because, of course, we had to wash her. We had no idea what she had on her. Although I do know the cats are clean creatures, and they will take care of themselves, but this one was just too small. And I washed her completely, dried her, and she was just there and nice. And then we decided to dry the shower cabin, put a bunch of blankets and stuff, and let her sleep there for the rest of the night. We really didn't know what we can give her to eat, and besides, we didn't really have anything to give to the cat to eat. We were pretty dry on food at this point ourselves, and we had no cat food at all, and it was too late. So we gave her a bit of yogurt, which we've heard it's okay. You can see it right here. We didn't give her any milk. I know that much. Water. And she pretty much spent the night here with every time we would leave her, every time we would basically leave the bathroom, she started meowing, but this was more it had nothing like a meow. It was completely different and weird. She had a bit of coughing. So we were like, yeah, I think we were up to like 3-4 a.m. trying to calm her down into not meowing the whole night, trying to make her fall asleep. And then we got up at like 7. We didn't have a lot of sleep that night, needless to say. And then we took her to the vet in the morning. She got a couple of injections, some medicine, some cure. Turned out she had a bit of a cold, which is why she sounded so weird. It's been, 5 days now? 4 or 5 days, and she still hasn't completely recuperated from the cold, but she is 50 times better now, by the way. And then we decided to go and start buying her food and stuff that we need for the cat, because we had nothing. And when we were done with that, we went to the bakery, and considering I was holding her, Mrs. Citadel actually went out, even though she's the driver, to buy some more things from the store and the bakery. And we were sitting in the car. It was extremely hot. And this is us. The bag you can see here is Twitch bag, Twitch goodie bag that I got in Berlin when we were at TwitchCon. And we put her inside because it was the most convenient thing. And then I couldn't let her leave because she wanted to constantly crawl into some parts of the car, which, well, it probably wouldn't end up being a good idea. I couldn't let her leave, but I didn't want to, you know, just shove her inside. So we had an agreement that half of the body can be outside, half of the body has to stay inside. It was really hot, and she slowly drifted to sleep. She's the cutest little thing. And this is as far as I let her out at the moment. She just basically hugged my arm and fell asleep there too. Because I could understand that it was really hot for her, but I just couldn't let her leave and crawl into some part of the car, which I won't be able to even reach later. That'd be a tragedy. I think that's about it when it comes to... Oh yeah, this one too. When it comes to the pictures, I do have a bunch of videos that I will show you as well. Bear in mind though that the video quality is going to be very poor for multiple reasons, and those reasons are basically it was night, it was recorded with a cell phone, and we didn't have the lights on. I was watching Game of Thrones. I started rewatching the entire Game of Thrones, by the way. It was about end of second season. Because I was so disappointed in how the 8th season ended that I just had to rewatch everything from scratch just to get some good moments back. Because Game of Thrones was really good right until the last season when they fucking screwed up everything. So I will actually be making this video in a couple of parts because I don't want to just start the video for you right now because it has sound and the sound is going to be, well, Game of Thrones. Don't want to get any copyright claims or anything like that. So I'm going to quickly turn off the video here and just edit it so you can continue watching. For you, it won't make any difference. I'll see you in a second. And we're back. You will be seeing a lot of different video clips that we recorded last night because if you follow me on Twitter and if you're joined on a Discord, you know that we have a cat for now a couple of days. And she's been preoccupying, well, basically most of our time that we're not... Oh, shit, that video is actually upside down. I'm going to have to find a way to not make it upside down. Well, I guess you will be seeing the video either upside down or not seeing the video at all. Might be an interesting thing. Okay, we'll see if I get it fixed. This is just the audio recording now anyway. She's been basically taking most of our time, and she's an amazing little thing. She is really, really special, like totally different, and we have decided that, well, 99% we're gonna keep her. Still didn't come up with a name, but the original, well, permanent name, the original name that we wanted to give her was basically Mrs. Citadel's. suggestion to call her Baba Yaga, because Baba Yaga is how John Wick is called. I'm sure you can Google what it means. It's nothing pretty, unlike her, but it was pretty convenient. You know, we watched John Wick 2, we watched John Wick 3. On the way there, we heard her the first time, and on the way back, we heard her the second time and decided to pick her up, and it was like, yeah. We call her a couple of different things, but still not sure. I really don't know what exactly to tell you. I mean, she sounds still a bit different, but she's a lot better. She started playing. She started, she definitely started eating. You can even see her belly. Like I said, if you're following me on Twitter, I'm posting at least one picture a day with her. And she's an amazing little thing. You will see a couple of clips here. She decided to randomly start drinking from a glass, or at least trying. We were playing with her. I got no words. She's just an amazing little thing. You asked for, you know, Discord, Twitch, Twitter, pretty much everybody has been asking for some cat videos. And I thought, well, Fun Sweet Hunts might be the best possible way to do it. I don't want this to be... I don't want people to think, ooh, he saw Jingles having a cat, now he's doing his own. Because Mrs. Citadel wants a cat for like 5 years now. I wanted a cat since forever, but I had a cat in the apartment before and it wasn't pretty. I was resisting. I was really resisting. As much as I wanted it, I really resisted, but I just couldn't resist this. I mean, she needed the help, and we got her, and then once you get her, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? You have to understand the situation here is you can't really give her anyway. You can try and gift her or sell her on the internet if somebody wants to pick her up, of course, but that you may need to wait forever. If you wait long enough, she's gonna grow on you, and then it's gonna be even harder to do it. There are shelters, but most of them are closed because they got no funding, and the ones that are open, well, this was some time ago, but I'm pretty sure nothing changed. They can keep the animals for like 7 days to maybe 14 days, and then they put them to sleep because they can't fund this. They just can't take care of the animals. So the animals there are like, please pick them up if you can take care of them. Otherwise, there's a very little chance that they'll make it. So, and you know, she's growing on us really, really fast. Really intelligent, smart, calm. She is finding herself around the apartment pretty fast. She learns pretty fast. She likes to play. She likes to get cuddled. Like pretty much any cat, of course. I don't know. I mean, we got a cat now. And it was a total coincidence. An absolute coincidence. And we weren't even supposed to go that night. We were supposed to go the day before. And that night when we went, we weren't even supposed to go take that path. We were supposed to go different path. It's weird. It's really, really weird. But I don't know. I will just let the videos roll. I have plenty of material. Most likely not even going to be able to show you everything. But there's a bunch of videos with her playing, us playing, and stuff like that. Couple of more things that I wanted to talk about. I had a pretty interesting morning. We keep her, by the way, in the bathroom. We gave her, you know, the place where she can go to the toilet and have water and food and toys and cushions and napkins and all this stuff. She's definitely living the life of a princess now. But most of the things we try to organize in the bathroom because we have a ventilation there, and whenever she needs to take a poop or a leak, whatever, it gets ventilated pretty fast. Anywhere else in the apartment, it takes a while to get rid of the smell, and the smell is really not nice. If you have cats, you know what I'm talking about. we are trying to transition her to eat and drink, and just stay pretty much throughout the rest of the day outside of the bathroom. But, you know, it's still throughout the night, everything gets put back in the bathroom and she has to stay there. Because I'm sure a lot of you know how interesting it can be when you wake up in the morning or you hear weird sounds in the night, where you just leave your cat in the apartment to wreak havoc upon everything she comes across. I have a whole bunch of cables, PS4, television, routers, billion cables, microphones, headsets, monitors, TV, speakers. And then, of course, there's a bunch of things where if she jumps high enough and she's kind of starting to learn how to jump and stuff, that she can reach food, glasses and stuff. And I was like, oh yeah, we're never gonna just leave her in the apartment, because we only have doors for the bathroom, for the room, and for the terrace. Everything else is a bunch of rooms connected to each other with hallways, with no doors. We're looking into getting some extra doors to kind of making our apartment more into compartments, kind of the apartment. But right now, she's confined to the bathroom every night, and she's getting used to it. At first, she would always start, wannabe meow when we would leave her. Now you just feed her, you cuddle her, and she falls asleep. So we left her in the bathroom. Mrs. Citadel got called to substitute this week, so she went to work pretty early. She fed her, and she left me some messages and stuff. But I walked out of the room, and the very first thing that I see is one bottle from a beer that's, of course, empty, in the middle of the hallway. And I see a bag of bottles kind of leaning, standing next to the door, flipped, and the bottles are kind of sticking out from it. And I'm thinking, no way that Mrs. Citadel let her out of the bathroom when she got up, because I could be asleep for hours more, and I was at least another 2 hours, because she left around 7:30, and I got up around 9:30. You know, it's not exactly safe to just leave the cat for a few hours to do whatever she wants. So I'm thinking, like, no way. I go into the bathroom, and the cat is in the bathroom. I'm thinking, like, what the hell happened here? How? What? And I can't put my mind around this, because one bottle is at the middle of the hallway, and then a meter or two away from it is a bag flipped full of bottles. I'm thinking, how did this happen? And I find a note, you know, take these bottles back to the store, and, you know, you can buy new ones without having to pay for bottles and stuff, and find a message to buy some other things and stuff. I'm like, yeah, that's fine, but why is this all flipped everywhere? Only cat could have done this. And then it hit me. My genius darling, which of course I later messaged her and checked it out and realized that this was actually what happened. We have a door handle. It's like any other handle, a normal one. But it's not edgy. It doesn't go on L. It's actually just curved. So you can't really put anything on the door handle and expect to use the door handle and not put everything on the floor. So the genius woman decided to stuff this bag with like 7-8 bottles and put it on an inside door handle. And then she left the apartment. Of course, she had to close the doors, so she used the handle. And everything just slided from the door handle and slammed on the hallway floor and broke. At least 2 or 3 of these bottles immediately broke inside of this, what would you call it? A bag. And one of them slided out right in the middle of the hallway. And of course, the natural thing for me was this had to be the cat. But then I realized, like a detective looking at the whole thing, I started to basically come up with a story. And the only question left for me was like, okay, woman, so you left out probably in a hurry and you closed the doors. This thing smashed on the ground. It created huge noise because a couple of bottles just broke. Then you just left it there? You son of a gun. She left it there, and of course she went to work, and she didn't even message me. And there's no way she couldn't hear this. I mean, sometimes I already put the headphones and start the music in the morning if I, you know, need to leave someplace and stuff. But I usually start the music when I leave the apartment. So even under those circumstances, in 7:30 in the morning, she would have probably heard it, even with the headphones on. And she doesn't listen to very loud music, so that sneaky little bugger. Then, of course, I called her to check everything, and she was like, yep, apparently that happened. Sorry. So, okay, the bag has to go because it's now filled with glass, and it wasn't one of those disposable bags. You can use it over and over. Yeah, whatever. And then I need to find a bag now to put the rest of the bottles, which are still, you know, good to be used. But we don't have any. We just don't keep any plastic bags anymore. We do, however, have trash bags. And the recent ones she bought are some purple ones, which actually look like a proper plastic bag that you would get in a store to carry stuff. The major difference is, it's thin as hell. It is extremely thin, but it is the only bag that I had at my disposal. So, okay, I can't use the bag, which is good to be used, because it's filled with glass, and I have to throw an entire bag, because we're gonna use this for bread and stuff later, and there's going to be crystals of glass everywhere. So, you know, don't want to risk it. Okay, this is the only bag that I have at hand. I put the bottles inside. I slowly lifted it up. It was okay. It was holding it together, and I'm thinking, whew, okay, it actually holds. Took the trash, took the bottles, left the apartment, went three floors down, got on the street, went to the trash can, got rid of the bag filled with glass and the trash that I had. Now I'm left with only this purple, super thin bag filled with like 5-6 bottles. Glass bottles, and halfway to the store, which is like 20 meters away, right in the middle of the street, I decide I'm going to open the bag just to count how many bottles that I actually have, because as soon as I enter the store, I'm going to put them out and tell cashier how many bottles I put. I open the bag and the floor of the bag just rips itself open, and all six bottles just smash on the asphalt right in the middle of the goddamn street, and two bottles break again, and four bottles are left standing there. And I'm thinking, you have got to be kidding me at this point. And what do I do now? Now I don't have a fucking bag at all. Why did this hell even broke like this? And I had a couple of people doing some works on the cars and stuff looking at me, and I'm thinking like, great, this is a great start to the morning. And all I wanted was just to rush to the market, get something to eat for breakfast, and start making these videos and stuff. So I had to basically pick all the pieces with hands, because you don't have actually broom or gloves or anything at that point, and it's right in the, well, almost at the middle of the street. You actually had the cars actually had just enough space to bypass it, but if I leave the glass, no one is gonna see it. And the funny part is, it's actually on the steep, it's on the curve, so cars are coming from the lower altitude, they're climbing, and then that's exactly where the whole thing gets flat, so the driver is never going to see all this glass. So I basically spent like another 10 minutes on the road, walking between the trash can, up and down and up and down, because it's even more elevated, just trying to get all of these little glass parts out of the road until there was basically really, 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 really super small ones that you just can't get rid of. And then I took the remaining four bottles, went to the market and be like, here they are. And I'm thinking to myself, I only lost half of them on the way, and I live in the same damn building in which I have the apartment. That was eight bottles. At least two broke when the woman left them on the door handle and then left the apartment and broke them. And then two broke between the trash can, which is 20 meters from my entrance, and the market, which is exactly in the same building, just on the other side. Oh! Anyway! And then, of course, I had to come back, start recording, editing, stuff like this. I got a whole bunch of materials for World of Warships that you, of course, probably see none of it, because I think the first part was about between 10 and 15 minutes, and this one is closing in on 20 minutes, so we're kind of running out of time for Fonts with Hunts. But I think I will just now immediately, considering I'm not streaming today, because today is Tuesday for me, for you, that this all happened yesterday, I think I'm just going to go and create a whole nother video about German cruiser Siegfried, tier 9, pan-European destroyer Frisland, tier 9 British, tier 6 British carrier Ark Royal, tier 10 Hayate, IGN tier 10 DD, and Thunderer, British tier 10 battleship, because all these things have been published as sort of a super test, and they're coming, and I'm sure a lot of you are going to be interested in this, because, well, at least two or three of these things are completely unique and something that you haven't seen before. And I will be making a video on that, and I will be linking everything for you to check it out yourself in the video that I create. Unfortunately, you didn't get the video of World of Warships today, even though I have it recorded and ready. But this video is already too long. I guess I'm going to keep that one for the next Fonts with Hunts. So if you were there for simply just World of Warships, I apologize. But there's a lot of people who wanted to see these videos as well. And I will always try to use Fonts with Hunts for something unconventional and different, because, you know, open hands in these kind of videos. I honestly don't know if there's anything anymore that I can start talking to you about that's not World of Warships related. And since I'm going to be doing a special World of Warships related video, then I'll just keep this out of it. I don't know. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you enjoyed the story. I love this new cat. It's growing on me super fast. She's super cute, smart. And yeah, both me and Mrs. Citadel are more than satisfied. And I think she is as well. She's definitely getting better. And yeah. So thank you all so much for watching. Leave a like if you liked. Leave a dislike if you didn't. Share, subscribe, all the good stuff. I really hate saying these things, but it seems to work. It seems like when you actually say these things, people do get more active in the comments, likes, dislikes, and stuff. And quick edit here. I will now quickly, shortly, briefly just show you the video footage of the ships that I was talking about that will be coming to the super test soon and that I will be making the video on. And it really does help the channel, of course. So today is not my streaming day, so I'm going to be spending the rest of the day working on some admin stuff, playing with my cat, and doing some IRL things. I will see you all... Well, I wanted to say tomorrow, but this is going to get published on Wednesday. So I will see you today on the stream, where we will be doing probably World of Warships and maybe Hell Let Loose. Which, speaking of, if you haven't seen, go check out yesterday's video. This is such a mindfuck to talk about. I have to pretend like it's tomorrow, and I have to tell you that you have to check things that are yesterday, which for me are today. Because today... this evening I will publish the first Hell Let Loose video. It's a brand new CBT game that will in a week, on June 6th, go on, early access. I got access to it. The game looks awesome. The sounds are good. Some mechanics and some physics are still iffy, of course, just like Postscriptum, but it definitely looks better than Postscriptum, although Postscriptum is still deep in my heart, still my favorite. But I just wish I could combine these two games and get a perfect product. We had a blast playing it. We will probably be playing it more. And yeah, if you haven't checked it out, check it out. I gotta close this video now. I don't know. Thank you for watching and have a good rest of the day. Good luck, and I will see you on the stream or with tomorrow's video.